So, in continuance of this discussion about the Fibonacci, okay, now we have Venus out there, the Venus planet. Now, interestingly, now you take the Venus and it goes into its trajectories over time, again and again and again. I spied from here on the Earth, and it creates like a beautiful flower, all of those trajectories again and again and again, all of its orbits, it creates a flower. It's just like, wow. So when we look at what it's doing, what it's become, you know, what it's giving out, what it's actually singing to us, it's singing, you know, from Venus to planet Earth. It's giving its input. We're being affected by the Venus planet. Because here on the planet Earth, we have the five, many of the five flower petals. Many flowers are doing that. So it's almost like they are listening to that same wavelength, and they come from the same sound. They come from the same sound. Okay, so we're talking about sound creating pattern. Okay. Now, certain sounds create patterns. Like you can have the sound creating the pattern of, like they have the violin. Now the violin making a specific sound will turn sand into different patterns, different shapes and forms. So not a big pile of nothing, well maybe if I played, but really distinct, very distinct shape, very much making their own Fibonaccis. So that's a sound moment. Okay, so we're having sound moments are creating these Fibonaccis. So things like the creation of patterns in animals, like in a zebra, pattern in a jaguar, pattern in a cheetah. These types of patterns are originally sound procreated. Okay, like when that species was becoming that species, and when all of a sudden, hey, look, there's spots on that one. There were sounds that were coming, that attunement sounds that were rearranging in those mother's wombs and creating these little spotted cheetahs. So this is like an incredible discovery. All of this Fibonacci, all of this CERN, as they go round and round with this atomic hit. Atoms hitting the commitments of that wave, the sound wave, to actually affecting and making a pattern. So that's what we're looking at. Especially African animals, they're so filled with patterns, aren't they? And you can imagine, and they've even gone back and they said, yeah, there were times when the stars were loud and whistling. The stars made lots and lots of sounds. And so it's very possible that way back when we had more listened to, more gain factor from outer space. And I know this sounds weird, but now we have Venus involved, okay? So what's going on now, because Venus is involved with the five pointed flower, it's impossible to take planet Earth and go over like 50 galaxies away and plant it there and say, hey, we're Earth, and we just showed up and we're gonna start making Earth again, you know. Apparently, we need Venus. You understand? We need Venus also. So it makes us kind of like, no, I don't think this is a movable factor on repeat, unless we have all of these other planets that are affecting us sound-wise. If we pick up, you know, all of the little goodies from planet Earth and we go 50 galaxies away and we transplant ourselves, we're gonna get different attunements. We're gonna get different strands heading in. Now, we could very well end up being similar. You know, maybe there's a planet like a Venus nearby. But we're talking rare now. We're talking a rarity now. If we want to mimic and have like a creation factor going on, like we want to recreate Earth as it is, it's evolving now in continuous evolution with no upset, because apparently now things are going to happen. We're going to lose the moon and we're going to fall into the sun. By the time we move away from here to other planets, we're going to want to recreate this factor. And we're going to want to continue our evolution. We're going to want to evolve with the creating of everything, of the species, etc., etc. So we're looking at now. We're looking at this new addition into the equation. It's like, hey, we're just not one-stop pony here that we can go over there and pick up and then just plank down on another planet that has water, you know, and we'll throw some fish in. It's not going to be like that. We're not going to have that same availability of creation that we have, because we have this beautiful Venus on give, saying, ha ha ha, everybody. That's a flower, and I'm sending it to you constantly. You know, that's like a sing-song. A sing-song all the time. So we're talking now, we are needing the instruments from outer space. We need the instruments from those planets to really start speaking to where we're going in our creation factor. Okay, now, so that's why this time frame is such a drudge chore, because we've got so many things that are just bleeping out and saying block, block, block. We're like mankind, you know, block everything, mankind, block with the space probes and block with the satellites and block with the sound of man. You know, we only want the sound of man everywhere, you know, block, block. And so thusly, you know, when it comes to like a time where like new things maybe want to happen, we're going to have new geckos, we're going to have new salamanders. I don't think this is a good time for them. I think we're having too much wall with all of these planets. It's like, how can we even get to you? How can we get to you, you know? I can't get my radio station heard. No, can Venus even get her radio station heard here any longer? You know, we can see the trajectory and go, woo woo, that's so cool what she does. We can see that, but is that, you know, the whir of her time, you know, the whir of her time makes a sound. All of this makes a sound. And when this is going on, creation is like supposed to be happening. You know, we're gonna have new fish, we have new primates, we have all of these things new happening. You know, this is we are evolving. We're supposed to evolve all the time. It doesn't just stop because, hey, it's year 2000 something. We're supposed to still keep evolving, but we put all of these blocks out there. Like a terrible orb with pinpricks. And so it's just like, maybe we're not, you know, maybe we're really vastly missing out on evolution. The evolution of species right now. Maybe we're really missing out. So that would be something to fix, you know, is to try to make sure we're not blocking our incoming. You know, if this is where our origins of this CERN is saying, these are our origins, creation, you know, this God particle, this is us. Hey, you know, I'm going to be like this, and you over there, you're going to be like that, you know. You know, in your swirl, and you're over there in that swirl. Oh, my mind is spazzing on all of the different colors in the swirls and what they represent, and what color are you in your swirl, and you know, are you a dark swirl? Are you in an under? Are you in a shallow? Are you in a hyped out? Are you full of jagged edges? Are you round and motherly? Or what, you know, all of these things, you know, when I think about your Fibonacci self, you know, people have so many things going, don't they? but yeah, but really now, we're talking about evolution, and I'm talking about the Fibonacci effect coming in from other planets, and wow. You know, if we are missing out on Mrs. Venus, if we're missing out on moving away, and we don't have Miss Venus there either, because we blocked Venus here, and then we go over there, and we don't have Venus anymore, we may not have those same beautiful flowers just all of a sudden grow in meadows. We may not have them deciphering and making and creating. Do you know what I'm saying? They're not going to get that same sing-song through. All right. Yeah, that's pretty heavy. I'm loving this information that I've gotten recently. You can all watch it. It's called Inner Outer. I believe Inner Outer Self or Inner Outer Planet. I believe Inner Outer Self. It starts out with the Buddhas and all. But it's... Fabulous insight, and I'm just elaborating on it, of course, because that's what I do. I'm very excited about it. I think it's one of the greatest discoveries that we have right now on our going forward commitment and where, how we're evolving, and are we stopping evolving? You know, are we stopping our evolution? The plants, the animals, the trees, you know, hey, that tree cannot hear to become, like, maybe that mulberry tree doesn't want to be mulberry anymore, it wanted to become something else, a mulberry manana, you know, and it can't become a mulberry manana anymore. So all of these things, you know, hey, we still want to talk to Venus, we still want to hear her, we still want to hear all of our surrounders, you know, no blocks.